What if I told you that there's some hidden knowledge about your wife that turns her on, makes her respect and need you more in her life? Now, I'm not talking about ancient knowledge from just hidden scrolls deep down under the sea. When I say hidden, it's secrets that I only unlocked after working with countless men as a dating coach. Yeah, I used to teach guys dating and seduction before getting my license as a therapist. I know. However, along with that experience, I did unlock truths about female psychology and attraction. Truths that I didn't want to believe at first. And you won't find it in books or from a therapist either. And honestly, it's kind of controversial to even share with you right now. However, once you learn these honesties, if you will, you will never go back. So today I'm going to share with you 5 flirting principles that you must start engaging in with your wife if you want a shot to win her back. And not only that, but completely flip the way she sees you. You'll turn pecks on the cheek to full-blown makeout sessions, cuddle sessions into puddle sessions, and just fighting into flirting, man, honestly. Now, the last one is going to sound crazy, but it will boost your testosterone by 147%. All right, for this first one, just take a look and tell me what you see.
I'm Gary.
I'm Celeste. It takes forever to get a drink around here. There's only one mattress. Oh. Don't go.
Those guys bother you?
Oh, they're fine. I mean, you just got here. You help yourself.
You like bourbon?
I love it.
Now, what did you notice there? Okay, there are a lot of things to take from that clip. George Clooney in that scene with Jennifer Lopez is unreactive. You see, naturally, as human beings, we are comparing ourselves in hierarchies with other people. Who has more status in a given situation, okay? In a context with the work, it's usually the higher ups, the boss. In context of school, it is the teacher. However, each person that has higher perceived status is always more unreactive. And I know watching a videotape with you and your wife at this point when you're watching this video of mine, I could tell you are much more reactive to her than she is to you. Therefore, you are perceiving her as having more value and more power. And thusly, a woman who perceives a man as having less power, less value, she loses attraction for, loses respect, and one of the core reasons why she is leaving you. Now, before we get into the next one, I just want to let you know early on in the video that if you need help saving your marriage right now, we have a call down below you can set up with our team to evaluate your marriage to see if we can help you save it. But let's get to the next one. For this next clip, I want you to ignore the context or the content of what he's saying, the words, and just notice his non-verbals.
Oh no, thanks, I don't smoke. Boy, you are just hitting on all 6 cylinders, aren't you? Would you do me a favor and just, would you just smile for me one time, just once? Yeah, yeah, you see, you got a short upper lip. Makes for a much nicer smile. See, I wonder what gives a beautiful woman like you pleasure. And say you're just standing there, right? And I just touch you just like this. See my fingertips. You like that? Do you? See, I want to learn what pleases you. I want to learn everything about you. Would you let me do that? Would you give me that job?
I'm off in a half an hour.
Well, I'm in room
217.
217. See you there.
Did you notice any nerves or anxiety? Was he hesitant to go touch her when she wasn't very vocal and happy and smiling naturally and authentically, or she kind of rejected him at first? Did he panic? Absolutely not. He used a deep downward inflection in his voice. He made strong eye contact. He closed in proximity. These are all natural signs of a man who has high value. Men who make strong eye contact, downward inflection in the voice, relaxed, open body posture, smooth gestures. And I can also tell if I watch another video clip of you and your wife, you're probably darting your eyes away. You maybe have an upward inflection in your voice saying like, hey, maybe we should go do this tonight, which sub-communicates to her in her limbic system, in her emotional mind, which is where she makes decisions to be with you or not, that you are lower value. And also, you probably are jittery, or at least most guys I talk to, when I speak to them, they talk really fast, they're nervous, I can tell. And if they're being that way with me, I only imagine how they are with their wives. Now, for this next one, I don't really need a clip to share with you, but rather a story. Now, Eric, one of my clients in the program, he dominated his whole entire life. Raised as the youngest of three brothers, competition just lit his soul on fire. With sheer will of mind and heart, he could bring anything into his existence, anything into his reality, except his wife's love back. There he was sitting in a multi-million-dollar home on the floor in tears as his wife stared at him with disdain. How could this happen? He never knew that much pain was in her heart. If she only told him, let him know that she was feeling that way over the years, she never truly let him know. I mean, he would have used his superpower to fix her heart, to fix things, like he fixed everything in his life. And though, even though Eric would dominate his body, his career, in every domain, when it came to his wife, he was weak. He lost his personal power that he once had with her. She literally floored a man who was 6'5" and full of muscle with one sentence. I no longer love you. You see, Eric thought that his wife wanted to make decisions and take on responsibility. I mean, she was so damn good at it. He swore like she wanted to do it. So when she uttered the words, I want to be with a man, not a boy, his ego was shattered. Doesn't a man provide food on the table? What does she mean by saying that? Eric never realized what millions of men fail to do until it's too late with their wives. She needed leadership and dominance and his unreactivity. Eric lost who he was over the years. If he looked at himself in the mirror, that was a truth that he had to accept. He sacrificed himself for everyone else in his life. In his words, I give the money away that my time creates. He never knew in those little moments where his wife didn't know what gifts to get the kids, she needed him there. One time on a road trip to Utah, she needed her husband to plan the trip so they wouldn't have to book the hotel last second. And on a macro scale, she needed her man to guide the ship of the marriage toward a future they can both fall for. Okay, so stick with me on this last one. I told you that you can increase your testosterone by 147%. I didn't make that up. All right, I used to also teach men how to quit porn. It's one of the other offers I had in the company, helping men with porn, and I developed this process of helping men save themselves from pornography addiction. Now, I'm not gonna go too in depth about that, but I wanna let you know, in my research of helping men quit this thing for good, I was looking for the benefits. One of the things I found was a study done where I took two groups of students, always students, and they had one group abstain, they did basically saliva glands. Like, here's the testosterone levels before this experiment. They both got off before. And then one group did it once a day and the other group didn't do it for 7 days. They measured the saliva of testosterone levels of the men who didn't do it for 7 days. And there was 147 increase in their testosterone. Now it does kind of level out at times, but overall what happens is that when you are constantly depleting yourself of your essence, you become weaker, you lose your testosterone. And men, let me draw this full circle with you. Men who have deeper levels of testosterone, higher levels of testosterone, they have a deeper voice. They are more confident. They are more going after dominance and what they want. That is that masculine hormone. And a lot of guys don't realize how low T they actually have. And so I'm not a personal doctor, but I know at least once a year, I check my testosterone levels, okay? And a lot of guys, when it comes to stress, lack of daylight, poor sleep, diet, and getting off, what happens is that they are shooting the testosterone down. The average 22-year-old today has the same testosterone levels as a 65-year-old man 100 years ago. Let that sink in for you, okay? So I only imagine what most men like yourself is at. I would recommend you check it out. Stop doing that and you'll see a difference, trust me.